Hey everybody, welcome back to Shadow of the Colossus. In this video, we're going to fight the 11th Colossus of the game. This is Celosia. Let me look that up real quick. Yeah, Celosia. Okay, so Celosia is a very interesting Colossus because up to this point, it's the smallest one so far. Kuromori, the, was it 9th Colossus, was it? That one was way smaller than any of the ones we've seen, but Celosia is even smaller than Kuromori. Now, for this video, I actually have to do something a little bit different. I'm actually doing post-playthrough commentary because the commentary file for the live version, it actually didn't happen. when I was recording, I actually was talking, but wasn't recording, so that actually went fantastic. And the thing was, I saved right afterwards, and I'm like, I didn't realize it until after I was like done recording. I was like, oh crap, I just messed everything up. So I got to do that, but it's only going to be for this video. For as of this recording, I am up to the 15th Colossus, and I really don't intend to mess up anymore, because I'm going to double check before like I save and stuff like that, that I do the commentary, don't mess up, and whatever. Okay, so Celosia, you get to it, and you gotta... Actually, it's a pretty lengthy journey to this Colossus. As you see, we're gonna cross the bridge, like, near the area where you fight the second one, but you're gonna go past that. And you're actually gonna go to, like... Oh, wow. Having trouble controlling aggro there. You're gonna go to, like... You're gonna end up in, like a canyon area with, like, a lake, and then there's, like, a temple, and that's where Celosia is. And the fight against it is very, very interesting because in order to actually damage it, you have to go through... it's like a couple steps in order to actually do damage to it and stuff like that. Because when you fight it, it's like armored, so you actually can't do anything to it until you knock off the armor. And the way you do that is pretty cool. Okay, so... I think there's like a tree or something like that over here. So, or not a tree, yeah, it's right there. A little save point area, and I'm sure you know what that means. A lizard. So, I'm gonna go after that. I think this one takes me a little bit to actually get. So, I'm gonna mess with that. But in the meantime, I'll talk more about the game. So after this one, there are 16 total in the game. And like I said, I've recorded all of them except the last two. And there's some really cool fights up ahead. one of the more interesting ones is number 14, I believe it is. You fight one kind of similar to Celosia, and I'll just say that. About Celosia. Like I said, it's a smaller Colossus. And because of its size, it's much more agile. And... It's a very aggressive one. Like the previous one, Dirge, was pretty aggressive. I mean, he pursued you like a lot and tried to knock you off of aggro and stuff like that. You're not going to have aggro for this one. For Celosia, you're going to be fighting it by yourself, and it's very aggressive. It will pursue you, and it'll try to knock you down and stuff like that. What am I doing here? Well, the thing is, like, for some of these things, like, I just can't remember what I was doing. Oh, I think I decided that I probably already got the lizard because I didn't see it, so I was just going to move on because I didn't feel like waiting anymore. Okay, so... I think I found out that I need to go... Yeah, I need to go a little bit farther here. Yeah, it's towards the end of this bridge, the one that leads to the temple. You'll see... Like, there's a canyon, and there's some, like, steps, almost. Like, well, it's like a ramp, series of ramps. And that's what you go down to get to where the Colossus is. And like I said, it's like in a, like a makeshift temple area. Oh, there's a tree here. I think I do pick up some fruits from this one. They look a little bit different from... the fruits that we've eaten before, because those were like I think those are orange or yellow or orange. These ones, like, you can barely see, they're like green. Did I shoot one there? I can't tell. Oh no. Yeah, I had trouble seeing the actual fruits here. Wait, did I find one? Maybe I'm thinking of a different one. Oh no, that's definitely one right there. Yeah, see? You can barely see that one. It's like green. I wasn't even sure if that was like a fruit that you could eat. And I'm like, I'll try it out. Yeah, that's definitely one. So you can see on the bottom right, the stamina bar gets a little bit larger. I think I only found that one. And I'm looking around for another one, but I think I just found that one. Yeah. Okay. So, like I said, this is the only video that I'm going to do this for. Like, it's actually happened before, and like a lot of my playthroughs, it happens at least once. And it really, like, I know a lot of people like the live commentary, and I actually prefer that way too. But, you know, shit happens, and can't really do anything about it. This is pretty much the best I could do. Okay, so I think if I remember, you have to go on the other side of this bridge, and then that's where the series of ramps starts down to the bottom. When I first fought this Colossus, like on the way there, I got completely lost. I had no idea where I was going. Like, I saw that it pointed down here. I'm like, okay, how the hell are you supposed to get down here? And eventually, after like 10 minutes of searching or so, I don't know. Well, at least a couple minutes. I don't know about 10, but it took me a little bit. I found like the series of ramps, and I was like, okay, so this is where you go. But once you go down there, it's kind of smooth sailing. It's pretty much obvious where you're supposed to go. Okay, I think I'm getting closer to it. Yeah, right there. You can see it on the left side. It's like a zigzag of ramps. And, yeah, you pretty much go to the bottom, and then you work your way down, like, a path, and then that's where the temple is, where Celosia is waiting for you. Like I said, Aggro will not be joining you here. You have to go down here on your own. I think I got a little bit lost. I'm like, okay, where did I just see that? So it's all the way down here. I really recommend just running down. I mean, it's a long run, but if you jump off, I'm pretty sure you die, like, instantly. So I would not advise that. But, I don't know if anybody asked. I don't remember if anybody asked, but there are some unlockables after you beat the game. There's, like, a hard mode and time attack mode. I don't believe I'll be covering those. I'm not gonna say no, but it's very unlikely that I will. That's just stuff, like, if you're really interested in checking that out, I would advise you to buy the game. I mean, even if you don't want to do that, you just want to, you know, check out the game and play it and stuff, I really recommend it. This, the Ico and Shadow of the Colossus collection is, like, great value for its money. And I know I'm, like, gushing over it, but I've yet to play Ico, but I've heard good things about it. But Shadow of the Colossus is fantastic. This is really one of the, like, best games I've played, like, ever. And I'm being serious about that. I've played a lot of games. But anyway, yeah, you do unlock those. I don't intend to cover those. This is just gonna be, like, a normal mode playthrough. But for the hard mode, that one is a little bit different. Like, the Colossi, sometimes they act a little bit differently. Some of them will, like, shake more and stuff like that. And, but for the most part, like, some of them will have a little bit different tactics. Some of them will actually have more symbols to stab, stuff like that. Okay, there was a little cut there. I actually paused the game. And, I think somebody's at the door or something like that. But it was, like, wasn't for me. But, that's where I stopped. And this is the temple right here. As you can see, it looks kind of like a temple. I don't know if it's exactly what that is, but I just call it a temple, and I'll be calling it that in the video here. Okay, and right here, I'm looking around for Celosia, because I know it's going to jump you. Like, it jumps from somewhere. I was trying to remember where it was, but I couldn't find it. But when I jump down there, I'm going to jump across. I was trying to figure out, and I was like, can you jump across? Because it looks like a pretty big jump, but you can. There we go. Okay, so this is Celosia, and I knew when you first see it, it charges at you. And I tried to run as fast as I could to get away from it, but as you can see there, it got me. And this thing is pretty ruthless. Like, as you're getting up, like, it'll attack you, so you actually can't avoid it. Look at that. I'm, like, stuck in the corner. I actually thought I was gonna die there. The good thing is that when Celosia rams you, like, if you've eaten enough health fruits... Oh, damn, I thought I was gonna get hit there. If you've eaten enough health fruits, they don't hurt you that much. You definitely want to avoid getting hit, of course, but they don't hurt you that much, so that's a pretty good thing. You can also hide behind here. Celosia cannot attack you from behind that pillar, which is just great because I healed off all the damage. Okay, so for this fight, it took me a while to figure out for the first time. It took me a while to figure out what you're supposed to do, and this is what you're supposed to do. Stand on the pillar there with the torch, and what it's going to do is ram it, and it's going to knock down like that stick right there. What you need to do is light that stick and pretty much walk towards Celosia, because Celosia is known as the Flame Guardian, and it's interesting because Celosia is actually afraid of fire. So once you grab the stick, just pretty much run and avoid it and try to light it up. I think here I'm like trying to figure out how am I supposed to light this up. But I just walked into it and it lit up, so. Right here, you can see Celosia is scared of me. I'm just like taunting it. Just like trying to whack it with the fire. But what you need to do is make it back up off this cliff. And you see the pieces of armor from its back are falling off, and you should pretty much know what to do here. You can actually end this pretty quick if you can land on Celosia from here. I tried to do it, but I couldn't. I missed. Oh, actually, after this, I missed. There you go. I did a pretty big jump. But if you miss, as you can see here, Celosia is pissed off that you knocked off its armor, and it'll attack you. And I actually get attacked a couple more times here. I'll just say that. I thought I was going to die because it would not let me get up and run away from it. Look at this. I thought I got away from it there, but apparently not. I think you might be able to roll through that, now that I think about it. But, you know, as it's running towards you, sometimes it's hard to react quickly. Well, at least for me. I'm just like, oh shit, I'm just trying to run away, or jump, or whatever. God damn. Very annoying Colossus here. Okay, but like I said, you can actually land on its back immediately, and... What you can do is, like, when you land on it, you can start stabbing the symbol on its back. And it's actually pretty effective because when you land on its back, it's still reeling from that fall. So you actually can get a couple hits in. And a fully charged stab does a lot of damage. Since Celosia is, like, way smaller than the other Colossi, it takes less fully charged stabs to actually kill it. And right here, I thought I could get away from it, but I didn't. And... What it's going to do, it's going to knock me, like, towards the lake. And if you need to... Oh, jeez, I thought I could get away from it there. If you need to recover health, you can just chill, like, near the water. Because it actually can't swim, so it kind of just runs around the lake. Waiting for you to get out. Okay, yeah, I was checking where it was. Straight ahead. Oh, I keep panning away from it. But that lighted area there, you can see, like, a ramp that goes up the mountainside. I don't know what you're supposed to do, because the first time I ever did this Colossus, I can't remember what I did. What happened was, Celosia was on the bottom part here, where we are now, and I was on the mountainside, and for some reason I didn't get it to follow me. Like, I got it stuck down here. In this video I actually did a completely different tactic, which, you know, was weird because I was trying to figure out what I was supposed to do. Like, okay, I know you can jump on its back, like, from, like, where it fell, but, like I said, I did something different. I kind of improvised because I couldn't figure out what I was supposed to do. So, actually, you might be able to... That those series of ramps that you came down, you might be able to, like, jump on his back from there. I don't know. But what I did here, because the first time I did this, I got on its back from here, like, up here. I don't know how I made it stay down there, but that's what I did. And I was actually a little surprised it actually followed me, because I thought, for some reason, it couldn't follow you up here, and it only stayed on the bottom part. So I'm like, oh, shit, he's following me. And this thing, like, relentlessly pursues you. It's, like, ridiculous. But anyway, I guess it showed me mercy there, because it... Oh, wait, never mind. I was gonna say he rammed the other way. And, yeah, this is... It's great. I'm just watching this, I'm like, God, this is so painful. But what I ended up doing here was I ran up this path, and this path actually leads you to where you started out. Like, with the torches, and if you actually, like, go back to where that was, you can actually jump on his back pretty easily, because you're gonna do what you did at the beginning, like, jump where the torches are, and you can jump on his back from there. Like, when he rams the torches, the pillars with the torches, it's, like, a little vulnerable, so you can jump on its back when it's kind of reeling from that ram. The only thing is, it just takes me a moment to get up there because this thing is kicking my ass. So, that process should be starting fairly soon. There we go. Okay, right here. You actually jump on its back from here. I think, if I remember it, the first time I jumped on its back, because, look, free jump right here. Once it gets close enough, anyway. But he kept, like, running. Like, he would not stop. So, let me see if I attempt. Oh, I'm recovering the health. Okay, okay. Yeah, I lost, like, half my health from that, almost. Okay, but, yeah, you can see the symbol on its back. It glows, like, pretty profusely. Right there. This thing's... going crazy, actually, on the top. Look at it. Okay, so I recovered most of my health. I was just like, you know what, screw it. I'm not going to recover all of it. I don't know what it's doing there, actually. See, I hesitated. Like, I held up the sword to charge, and I wanted to wait a little bit longer, like a split second longer, but Celosia started bucking me. So... Right here, if I remember, I start running out of stamina, so nothing's gonna happen. I'm just riding it. And you can see, actually, you get to see how much it it moves around when you're on its back. It's actually really annoying. Yeah, look at that. I think I might do one quick stab here, just to, like, hit it. Because what I was trying to do was stab it quickly, and while it's, like, reeling from the hit, I was gonna do, like, a longer one. But, like I said, I don't think I got to do much here, if at all. Anything at all. See how much it moves? It's like really... I'm just watching it. I'm like, damn, that's annoying. But there's the quick stab. See, I was gonna do another stab here, but it just kept moving around, so it was kind of pointless. And on the bottom right, you can see my stamina bar is blinking already. So it's just gonna keep moving around. I think I jump off, like, around this point here, and just get to higher ground. That's pretty much what you do anyway. Like, if you start running out of stamina when you're on this thing's back, just let go and just run to higher ground, so you don't get, like, rammed into. See, it jumped over here, which I had no idea you can actually do again. Oh, I got another stab in. But yeah, I had no idea it actually runs back up here. Oh, I almost had a big stab there. Okay, and so here I'm just like, ah! Just ran for this thing. Okay, so it lost, like, maybe a fifth of its health already. See, right there, right after it rams, that's when you can jump on its back. So it's just gonna keep doing it, so you don't have to worry about it too much. Like, getting a hit in. The only thing is, like, when it rams the pillar, you scroll backwards. It's kind of annoying. I think here I get a pretty big stab. You actually can see how much damage, like, a fully stab. Well, I don't want to say fully charged, because I don't know if it's fully charged, but a pretty decently charged one. How much damage it does to Celosia. Again, well, the thing about this game, there's a lot of different tactics to do with dealing with these Colossi. For the most part, I usually do, like, you know, I guess what the game wants or whatever, but there's a lot of different ways. Like, I actually just read the previous Colossus, Basaran. You can actually get on its back without having to deal with the geysers. I had no idea. Like, they're a little bit more difficult to do, though. But it's actually pretty interesting. So yeah, there's a couple different ways to do damage to these Colossi. It's actually really cool, too. Oh my god, just watching this is just like, man, this thing is annoying. I actually like this fight, it's just annoying at times, like this. Yeah, I got like a really quick one in there, did a little bit of damage. This thing, it's just running around way too much. It shakes a lot. Yeah, I'm about to lose my grip again. Oh jeez, it's just watching this, like, ah. Alright, but again, another retreat. That'll make your stamina bar fill up really quick. Look how quick it's filling up right now. Yeah, I think, I mean, this one took a pretty decent amount of time to actually defeat. I want to say the one that's going to take the most time. I mean, I recorded most of the ones in the game, and, oh wow, that did a lot of damage. Some of them are, like, decently, they have, like, a pretty decent length. I don't think they're as long as this one. There might be one or two that are, but the one that's probably going to take the most time is definitely Malice, the Last Colossus, because you have to do kind of a lot to actually damage this thing. And plus, like, you actually have to make it to the Colossus. Like, there's like a... I'm not going to talk too much about it. But yeah, there's a lot to do. I can't remember how close I am to killing this thing. It's pretty close. Look at its health right now. There we go. And the Flame Guardian has burned out. And, I actually got asked if I plan these things in advance. And, no, I don't. I kind of just done. That's why some of them are really bad. So my little things when I stab, do the final stab. I don't think that one was actually used when I did the live recording, but like I said, it didn't happen. The commentary didn't save. Okay, so that was the, what number is this? 11. Okay, Colossus 11, this is Celosia. Interesting battle. Kind of annoying at times, but... you know, it was okay. Some might like it better than I did. Alright, but I'm going to save here. Again, sorry for the different commentary, but that's all I could do. Alright, but yep, saving here, and in the next video we'll go back to normal and we'll fight the 12th Colossus.
You.